The homeless crisis and the people that just passed away over the last week or so. I think we have 4 deaths to date.
Yeah.
Due to people dying on the streets. You know, we had one girl in particular that took her own life through suicide.
Yeah.
Due to homelessness. You know, we're in the worst housing crisis ever. I think we're up to 8,000 now homeless. We've 3,000 children homeless. And it's getting worse by the day. It really is getting worse by the day. And we're not even into the winter yet. You know, and the fear is that we're going to have more deaths on the street unless there's immediate action taken and the housing crisis addressed. What we've been appealing is we've been asking the state to build more affordable social housing.
Yeah.
You know, to meet the needs of homeless people. We've also asked, and we're not the only ones that have asked, all the other supermarkets out here in the street have done the exact same thing. We've asked government to cap the rent in the rental market, because we've seen more families be forced out into homelessness due to some certain landlords raising rents. There would have been a stigma a few years ago towards homelessness, people, alcohol, drug issues, mental health issues. That's not the case anymore. What we're finding is when we're out on the streets, on our soup run and on our outreach, that they're not only people with alcohol or drug issues or mental health issues, it's people that have lost their jobs and couldn't afford to pay their rent. We actually know a few cases on the street, a few rough sleepers asleep in doorways, that they actually go to work the next morning and come back and sleep in a doorway because they can't afford to pay their rent.
Yeah.
Most people are priced out of the rental market, you know, because the rents are so high. You know, we've a lot of boarded up houses all over the country that could be revamped and brought back into use.
So what do you feel about the lack of media today? Because, right, I'm a mum.
Mm.
I'm going live on Facebook here.
Yeah.
I believe that if we use this medium, we can create change.
Of course.
But isn't it time for us to make a difference?
It's time for the public to come together and make a stand. Enough is enough.
Yeah.
One death is too much, never mind four.
Well, maybe it's time we took it into our own hands, because if we don't get the support from the people around us in power, why don't we put ourselves in power by using media?
I remember Apollo House last year. We had the whole country on our side.
Yeah.
You know, and Apollo House made a big, big difference last year. I remember last Christmas when we done Apollo. We took as many people as we could off the street.
Yeah.
When Apollo closed up, the doorways started filling up again.
Yeah.
You know, the homeless people's needs are just not being met.
No,
you know, and it's so, so sad. You know, we have young children that come to us right outside this Bank of Ireland here across from Trinity College. And the nights that we're out on that soup run, we'd have at least 300-400 people waiting on us to set up at 7 o'clock. And this ranges from rough sleepers to people that have got homes that can't actually afford to put food on their table.
Yeah.
Families that come from hotel emergency accommodation that don't have cooking facilities. And we give them hot food, because the way it is in hotels, families with young kids are in one room. They're using their bed for a table. You know, kids are falling behind with their schooling.
Yeah.
You know, it's just so, so sad. The mental health is kicking in. I can only imagine in my head here what it's like for a family with 3 or 4 children to be in one room.
Yeah.
You know, you have
to let
kids...
Well, it's bad enough for parents anyway with a normal environment to get through what's going on in the world. So I totally get that. I totally understand, because I have 3 kids and I was panicking about rubbers and rulers and everything else. As a single parent of 3, that was pressure enough. But my heart goes out to anybody that has to suffer through that and is suffering now. But not just that, the male partners as well. The pressure on them to support a family and pay the rent in an extortionist country.
I think if we implemented that, policies get changed in the rental market and we build more social housing.
Yeah.
Like, the way it is for some landlords, it's a business. Not all landlords, but some landlords, it's a business.
Yeah.
Okay? If we cap the rents, right, that we need to stop the flow. We need to stop the flow of homeless people becoming homeless every week. It's just increasing. Day by day, the homeless crisis is getting worse. So I think by building more affordable social housing to meet the needs of homeless people, that'll bring down the rental market.
Yeah.
You know, because there won't be such a demand in the rental market for private properties, because we'll have social housing built
up. But we have 250,000 buildings there, we've 100,000 local buildings, and we've 9,000 homeless, so why can't the government supply the 10,000 for the homeless, and let's then work on the rest, because NAMA could buy these buildings.
100%.
NAMA could. And also all those banks that made a nice little profit, why didn't they hand over like 5 million each into a fund, get the government to build houses for the homeless, and then we take on the social problems.
If we look back on all the money that was spent in hotel and managed accommodation, right, which was a temporary fix. Okay, the same with these hubs that are being implemented. They're temporary fixes. We need permanent solutions, not temporary fixes. And the only way we're going to get a permanent solution is by building more social housing.
I agree.
It's as simple as that.
So well, how can we do Fatima Mansions? How can we could do Dolphins Park? How come in the recession, the hardest times ever, we were able to build them? So what's the problem? Where are we going to adjust this?
I don't know. There just seems to, at the minute, just seems to be a lack of political will at the minute.
Well, you know, maybe we need to make that will happen. And give a little nudge.
I think by the public, the people coming out on the street and highlighting, enough is enough. We need change. As I said, the winter's not even in yet. Okay? And it's going to get worse before it gets better. If there's not immediate action being taken to address this homeless crisis.
All right, Tony, thank you so much.
No problem.
You're brilliant.